Turkish Friends. Welcome to my goals wrap up video part 2. In this video, I will first of all talk about the books that I've read for my yearly goal of being more social on BookTube. I will cover the books that I've both read as well as the books that I've read for my online book clubs. And in the second part of the video, I'm going to cover the TBR books that I've read for my special projects, including the books of Alfred Hitchcock and BookTuber recommendations. In the year 2022, for my big books but read projects, I chose 6 books that were more than 500 pages and decided to buddy-read those books with friends who wants to buddy-read it with me in the course of 2 months. The first book that I've chose was Pieces of Her by Karen Slaughter. I buddy-read this book with Alice and Loretta in the months of January and February, and I gave the book 9 out of 10. In the months of March and April, I read The Blind Assassin by Margaret Atwood with Kevi at Ses Kevi, and I gave that book 8 out of 10. For the months of May and June, I buddy-read Warbreaker by Brandon Sanderson with Gaia, Amy and Tara. And I gave that fantasy book a 9 out of 10. In the months of July and August, I could not find a friend to buddy-read Jonathan Strange and Mr. Norrell by Susanna Clarke with me. And I read that book by myself and gave that book an 8 out of 10. Likewise, nobody wanted to buddy-read Helter Skelter by Vincent Bugliosi with me for the months of September and October, and I gave that book a 9 out of 10. And the last book that I chose to buddy-read was The Poisonwood Bible by Barbara Kingsolver. I buddy-read that book in the months of November and December with Mindy, Jack and Loretta. I gave that historical fiction book a 9 out of 10. Other than these 6 books, I also buddy-read 13 books with other friends. The Big Books Buddy-Read project was certainly a big success, considering that I gave all of the books either 8 out of 10 or 9 out of 10. Even though I decided to change the read-along process to the series, I think buddy reading books with friends helps me to enjoy the books much, much more. In the year 2022, I read a total number of 37 books for my real life and online book clubs. In this video, I will talk about the books that I've read for my online book clubs. For the Killer Reads book club, which is hosted by AJ Dunn Reads and Writes, I read The Talented Mr. Ripley by Patricia Highsmith and gave that book 8 out of 10. Then I read Enduring Love by Ian McEwan and I also gave that book 8 out of 10. Next, I read The Widow by Fiona Barton and I gave it 7 out of 10. The last book that I finished for this book club was Alien by Otessa Mosfek and I gave that book a 6 out of 10. I tried to read One Flew Over Cuckoo's Nest by Cam Casey, but I unfortunately could not get on with the writing style and I had to DNF that book, even though I watched the adaptation and really loved it. The second book club that I joined was 1001 Books Book Club, which is hosted by Sandy at Miss Reads A Lot. For this book club, I read The Sea by Aris Murdoch and I gave that book 6 out of 10. For Jane Austen July, I reread Mansfield Park by Jane Austen, which was the book club pick for that month. In November, I started H is for Hawk by Helen MacDonald. But because I was very busy and I could not read a book that is dealing with grief, I temporarily DNF'd that book, but I will get to it in the near future. I'm also a member of Krista's Patron Book Club. And for that book club, I first reread The Murder of Roger Ackroyd by Agatha Christie. And I gave that book 10 out of 10 again. Then I read The Shape of Tundra by Jaswin Varga. And gave that middle grade book an 8 out of 10. After that, I read Dear Mrs. Bird by A.J. Pierce and gave that book 8 out of 10. And lastly, I read The Silent Sister by Diane Chamberlain and gave it a 7 out of 10. I also tried to join Christafest as much as I can and also take part in the discussion. For that group, I first read the Turkish edition of the graphic novel And Then There Were None and gave it 8 out of 10. I then read another Turkish edition of the graphic novel Death on the Nile and I also gave that graphic novel an 8 out of 10. I then read Sparkling Cyanide and gave it 8 out of 10. After that, I reread Death in the Clouds and did not change my rating of 8 out of 10. Likewise, I reread Sleeping Murder by Agatha Christie and gave it 8 out of 10, which was the same rating that I previously gave. Following Sleeping Murder, I read the Turkish edition of the graphic novel The Secret Adversary and gave that graphic novel a 6 out of 10. In October, I read Halloween Party and gave it 8 out of 10. And lastly, in December, I read the short story The Adventure of the Christmas Pudding and gave it again 8 out of 10. I also joined Kate Howe's Zoom group including mystery books. We first started the year deciding to read the Molly Murphy Mysteries by Rhys Bowen. I joined the group with the second book because I had previously read the first book. For February, I first read Death of Riley and gave it 8 out of 10. I then read The For the Love of Mike and gave it 7 out of 10. And lastly, we read In Like Flynn from the same series and I gave that book 8 out of 10. Even though I was still enjoying the series, majority of the group decided not to continue reading the series and we decided to choose another book, which was The Frances Affair by Josephine Tay. I really did like that book and gave it 8 out of 10. This project has mostly been successful. There are a very few books that I gave 6 out of 10. And I gave majority of the books that I read for the book clubs 8 out of 10. So I will continue trying to participate in the online and real life book clubs in 2023. For Books of Alfred Hitchcock projects, in the year 2022, I read the 12 works that were adapted to movies directed by Alfred Hitchcock. I also tried to do special videos about this project as I read 3 works and watch the 3 adaptations afterwards. I have made the 3 videos because I actually read the last book just today. So the 4th video regarding the 2022 books will be online in January. And the 12 works that I've read for this project were The Pleasure Garden by Oliver Sandys. I gave that book an 8 out of 10. Then I read The Ledger by Mary Bello Lowndes and I also gave that book 8 out of 10. After that, I read The Farmer's Wife by Adam Philpott, which was a play. And I gave that play a 7 out of 10. I also read a play Easy Virtue by Noel Coward. And I did not enjoy that play and I gave it 5 out of 10. The next book to read was The Manx Man by Hal Caine. And I gave that book an 8 out of 10. Then I read a play by Sean O'Coysey, Juno and the Peacock. I gave that play a 7 out of 10. Another play followed, which was The Skin Game by John Galsworthy. And I also gave that play a 7 out of 10. Following the Place, I read number 17 by Joseph Jefferson Farjon. So this was my least favorite book that I read for this project in 2022, and I gave that book a 4 out of 10. Following number 17, I read the 39 Steps. But because I have read the book very, very recently, I read the play adaptation by Patrick Barlow. I had previously given the book an 8 out of 10, and I also gave the play, which was a comedy of the book actually, also an 8 out of 10. The next read was a short story collection, Ashendon or the British Agent by V. Somerset Maugham. I gave that short story collection 5 out of 10. Next, I read A Shilling for Candles by Josephine Tay, and I gave that book a 7 out of 10. And I finished the year with The Wheel Spins by Ethel Lina White, and I really did love that mystery and gave it a 9 out of 10. When I look at the ratings that I gave, I can say that this project is a very exciting project for me, because some of the works made it to my most surprising list, whereas a couple of them actually made it to my least favorites of the year. So I can never know what will happen with this project. I'm liking this experience because sometimes uncertainty makes the reading projects a bit more exciting. The other TBR project was to choose books that were recommended by booktubers. I chose the names of the booktubers from a glass and watched that booktubers best of 2021 video, and chose a book from that video to read in the month. The first booktuber that I chose was Naomi, and I read Becoming by Michelle Obama by her recommendation, and I gave that nonfiction memoir an 8 out of 10. I then read Seb's recommendation, which was Electra by Euro PDS. I gave that tragedy a 7 out of 10. The next booktuber that I chose was Gemma. And I read The Power of the Dog by Thomas Savage from her video and gave it an 8 out of 10. Next, I read The House in the Cerulean Sea by T.J. Clune, which was Vicky's recommendation, and I loved that middle grade book and gave it 10 out of 10. Next book was Prenacy by Susanna Clarke, which was Britta Bohler's recommendation. I really wanted to devote my time to reading this book, and I did not have much time for extra books in my TBR, but I will definitely read this book in the first half of 2023. The next book that I read was Heartstopper by Alice Osman, which was Gaia's recommendation, and I gave that graphic novel an 8 out of 10. Next, I read Mr. Loverman by Bernardina Evaristo, and I also gave that book an 8 out of 10. Then came the second book that I could not read, An Unnecessary Moment by Rabbi Alamandin. This was Shelley's recommendation, and like Prinese, I will definitely read that book in the first half of 2023. The next book that I read was Boyfriend Material by Alexis Hall, which was Clint's recommendation, and I gave that book an 8 out of 10. The next book that I chose was A.T. by Roxane Gay. This was Marissa's recommendation, and I unfortunately had to DNF that book because the stories were too short for me to care at all. Next book was a middle grade fantasy book, which was Kiki's Delivery Service by Ayiko Kadano. This was Kaylee's recommendation, and I gave that book a 7 out of 10. And the last booktuber that I chose was Ellie. And I chose Miss Pettigrew Lives for a Day by Winifred Westert from her video. I actually started reading this book just today. Most probably I will finish it in the first days of 2023. I decided to give a break to this project in 2023. The reason was that I needed to decrease the number of physical books that are increasing in an alarming amount in my bookshelf. I'm thinking of going back to this project in the future years because like you can see in the ratings, the books were actually hits for me, with the exception of just one. And it's always great to have a recommendation from my BookTube friends. So this was the second and the last video that I made for my 2000 goals wrap up. As an evaluation of the both videos, I can say that I have achieved almost all of my goals. And with the exception of a couple of months, I actually did not try very hard to reach these goals. When I have too many options to read, it's actually easier for me to progress if I somewhat limit myself to a more structural goal. I know it's not the same for everybody. That is the way that my reading process works, clearly. That's why I also created goals for 2023, which seems a bit much when you think about the number of the goals. But the content of most of my goals are flexible, like 2022 goals. Please comment down below, how did you do in your 2022 reading goals? And last but of course not least, if you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye. As for Turkish word of the day, I'm going to choose Cerulean, since The House at the Cerulean Sea was the big success among all of these books. Cerulean means gök mavisi in Turkish, and gök mavisi are our Turkish words of the day. Have a good day!